actually Sabir Bay. I mean, info@thesabirbayshow. That's the email. But you can find me on it.
Okay.
All right, family. But I would love to come down there, man. Like I said, I'm on the East Coast, like mid-May. You know, I'll be around that area. All right.
I'll stay in contact. I'll definitely stay in contact. Whatever I can do to move around and get you here, brother, get you talking to the brothers, I'll make happen.
All right, brother. Hit me up on Facebook, though. Inbox me, though, brother. All right. And I'll give you all the details who you need to contact. All right.
Say no more. Appreciate it.
Yes, sir. Peace. Appreciate you, brother. We have another caller. Peace. Caller, welcome. What's your name? Where you calling from?
Hello.
Yes, caller. Where you calling from?
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
All right, yes. All right, this is Brother Curtis from Austin, Georgia.
Hey, brother, what's going on, Curtis in Georgia?
Peace. How's everything?
Hey, nothing. I just had a lot of questions. I'm trying to, you know, I'm not national or anything, but I just had a lot of questions. You know,
we can see we can squeeze them in half an hour.
How do I get more involved in the mission? Because I see a lot of brothers getting killed around my way from the police and things like that.
That's crazy,
and
man.
The main reason is because we're calling ourselves black. And I'm learning that it takes you changing your mindset for you to, you know, to understand. And I just want to get more information because I'm hungry for the knowledge.
Well, you know what, brother? Like I told the brother, if you can inbox me, I'm here for booking, man. I'm ready to roll out. I'm leaving on the East Coast on around about the 13th, 14th, around that time frame, heading back east. But if you are following me on Instagram or Twitter, or just inbox me on Facebook, we're right. trying to set up different, you know, people in different areas so we won't have to be there. You know what right. I mean? Because brothers are actually asking Brother Taj and myself to actually do a tour. You know what I mean? I'm like, Taj is like mad busy, and I know I'm busy dealing with the show and my lectures, and we're working on a reality show. But I'm here. Right. You know what I mean? Like I said, if somebody can book it, make it happen, I'm there, brother.
And you can always do.
You actually said something that touched with me. You said it, you know, a community, and you know, I feel like if I can, you know, get a better understanding of what's going on. I got six brothers and sisters. They got nieces and nephews. That's can build a nation right there and there.
Right.
There you go.
You know, it starts small. I'm starting to understand. You have to take baby steps.
Yeah.
To get the bigger picture.
You definitely do.
But let me share this with you real quick. If you listen to the show or any of the show, that's why we tell people to tweet these shows out, share the shows out, because it's something in every last one of the shows from Tuesday to Friday, brother. You're gonna get some jewels in here. And what happens, you will be more advanced than majority of the politicians that you run across. Even in my classes that I give in Long Beach, I tell people, get these books. Invest in a law dictionary. Not because you want to be an attorney, all right? But you must know the language of law, in law, period.
Yeah.
Get a thesaurus dictionary. Get an unabridged dictionary. No matter how much these things cost, they're not expensive, though, brother, but I would tell people, and get these books, you know what I mean? And
you gotta have these books.
Lock yourself in the room sometimes, or get books on J.A. Rogers, you know,
John Henry Clark, Dr. Ben,
you know,
Professor Small, Asa Hilliard, Eshwar Kwesi. There are a plethora of people. I carry around a lot of books. My version of the Bible is Who Betrayed the African World Revolution by Dr. John Henry Clark. This is my book of books. I recommend this book above a lot of other books simply because it is a foundation on which we can get people to understand why it is so important that we stick together and that we build together. We have to...
What's the name of that book again?
The name of the book is called Who Betrayed the African World Revolution by Dr. John Henry Clark. And I'll hold that up just so people can see. And the book costs like $12 or $13. It's not even an expensive book. Also, I tell people to read The Miseducation of the Negro by Carter G. Woodson. And these are all books that are inexpensive and full of information, because we have to remember that this is what the elders and our ancestors died. This is the information that they spent their life work trying to set up, as well as Dr. Ben and some of our other scholars. And so we have to take this information and see how we can apply this to our everyday life in order to improve our conditions as a group.
Pick that other book up for him so the brother can actually see 100 Amazing Facts about
And we also have 100 Amazing Facts about the Negro by J.A. Rogers.
I'm looking at the show from my phone, but for some reason it went out.
You say it went out?
Yeah, it went out.
But you can you can go online, brother. Yeah, it went out. Just go online.
And you can find it online, or you or your local your local African bookstore should have it.
If they don't have it, tell them well.
And I like to give people introductory books that don't have a lot of pages because I realize that a lot of our people haven't picked up a book in a long time to read. I don't mean you specifically, but, you know, a lot of our people will find a lot of reasons on why they shouldn't read books. This is another book, and it's called If You Want to Learn Early African History, Start Here. It's a book by Robin Walker. Again, this book only has 87 pages, but it's all about different nations in Africa and what they did during their great time in history, you know. And so we have to have these so that we can show our people that we are more than just slavery and the civil rights movement. And people also have to learn their lineage and learn where they come from, because that's who you are and that's what you stand on.
Exactly.
And yeah, even in the in what you call the Black Knight, they called Martin Lawrence Moore.
Well, Hollywood always tells. There's a skit, just giving you a hint here and there, but you just have to pick it up. But let me tell you the scenario how it happened in the movie Martin Lawrence. It was a stupid movie, right? Very stupid. I ain't gonna lie.
Black Knight.
It's like one of the Martin Lawrence worst movies. But what happened? There was a message that was in it. When he was fell in the water, he became unconscious.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. When you underwater for a certain amount of time, you become unconscious. So what happens when we were hitting our head? Where they say Hiram Abiff has been hitting his head and knocked unconscious. So now, so the whole scenario in the movie, Martin went back in time at this particular time. Remember, I didn't know it was a Normandy street out here in LA until I moved out here.
Yeah.
So I'm watching Normandy. I said, wait a minute, hold up. So they went back in Normandy. So at that time frame, they called them Moors, right? So Martin kept saying, what is with this Moor thing? It's our people today.
Right.
What is with this Moor thing? You know what I'm saying? So he became conscious. Once he became, he got knowledge. You follow me? So when he got knowledge, he said, oh, okay, I got it. Remember, they was trying to sell the park. And he said, man, get rid of the park. It doesn't matter. He was talking about all that, right?
Mm-hmm.
But when he became conscious, he said, no, we can't do that. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it was a stupid movie, but it was to try to show you, here it is. We're trying to tell y'all we're Moors.
Yeah.
But he said, I'm getting tired of this Moor thing more and more. In the movie, he said this. The dude called him Moor through the whole movie. There's another scene called True Romance. If you have the skit, I believe somebody posted it up there. They have the song with Stevie Wonder playing in the background. It said, in 1492, when y'all came upon these shores, 700 years educated by the Moors. The song is called Misrepresented People. Go Google it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, the scene in the movie was Christopher Walker and Dennis Hopper in the movie. And Christopher Walker was talking to Dennis Hopper. And Dennis Hopper told him, I don't know if you know it or not, it's a fact. He said, don't believe me, look it up. He said, I read a lot. And the Moors was spawned by niggas, and the Moors are niggas. So even in there, they're telling you. But what happened, for some reason, we fell back to sleep. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We've been hit in our head and dug in that shadow grave.
Yeah.
The majority of your ministers in the churches are in Masonic lodges. And every last one of them know exactly who we are. And actually, in colleges or high schools, I'm giving y'all keys. And this is
you didn't
learn
any of this in college.
And this is my
brother. I got my master's. Yeah,
Lauryn Hill said. Wow. Lauryn Hill said, "Masters of mass confusion."
Wow,
that's what Lauryn Hill. Lauryn Hill said, "Masters of mass confusion." So now,
all that money spent.
Now follow me. I'm showing y'all something that we were the mothers and fathers and the teachers, but yet they get you in debt.
Yeah.
Right, that's a debt that you can't never pay off.
For information, which is student loan, be free.
Right?
How many of these books can you buy for all the money it would take to get a master's? Every one of them, right?
Listen, Dr. Ben gave to the Nation of Islam 11,000 books.
Wow.
Now imagine.
And he did all of his studying abroad. He didn't get not one degree here in the States. All of his degrees were abroad.
And this is why we arm people, Rich. And we say, listen, the money that we spent on books, we probably spent God knows how much on books. No lie. Yeah. I have a library, dude. And most of the library is in my head now. But it's constant. And I never read a full book. I'm not even going to lie. I never read none of my books fully. But it's like, you know, I'm a speed reader. I'll speed it and it's in my head. Okay, I got it. Now I'm going to repeat it back to people. Now, dealing with colleges, when people go to colleges or high school, this is what they hide from you. It's sitting right in front of your face, right? It's called a mortar board. Mortar boards holds masonry. The feathers that Moors wear on their heads is actually that, the universe. It represents the wound of the woman. So in colleges, you have 90, 90, 90, 90, or 45 degree around each angle. And you turn the tassel from one side to the other side. That's a fez that you're wearing on your head, and people don't even know that. It's called mortarboard, which holds mason. So the mothers and the mothers are
mortar.
Yes, the mothers are the builders.
Yeah.
She the one that builds without a nail or screw or a hammer.
Mortar holds bricks together.
Exactly, and that's what happens. So once you teach people that and you get into this Moorish history, for real, you'd be like, dude, I created you. I started you. The Europeans are our children. My son. They are your children. So what happens? You put your children back in order. And the problem is we call them white. They're not white. Their names are Incavans, Troglodytes, Caucasians, or Europeans. That's who they are. Once you understand that, you will never hear a Moor call one of those people white. You will hear them say European. Mm-hmm. And if you understand the language, Euro means founded a peon. Peon means slave. Troglodytes, cave dwellers. Once you understand this, you will get it. You will understand the history behind it. Again, that is the big secret that they're holding from black people. You see what I'm saying? And we know that all these brothers are in the lodge. When you have Shriners, a Shriner protects a shrine. This is how it is, right? So who's dead? It's something that be worshipped, right? Just like a caretaker protect dead people. Who's walking around here dead mentally, calling themselves black? Think about it. Yeah. This is what happens. So as light bearers, our job is to shine a light on the ones that don't have the light.
Exactly.
That's what's happening.
Do you mean by that the lost found nation of peace?
Well, they all came out. They all came out of the Moor. They all came out of Noble Drawley's camp. None of them came. None of them was before Noble Drawley.
And let me say real quickly, as you speak about the Moors, particularly here in America, there's always been a romantic fascination in America about the Blackamoors.
Well, Blackamoor means black like a Moor.
Exactly. And the Moors, who conquered so many lands, have a deep sense of reverence, although it may be shrouded and shielded and hidden from the world. The Blackamoors or the Moors have a very revered place in history, in America as well.
Let me share this with you, man, because a lot of people.
And my dad was, you know.
No, we all Moors. Yeah. Well, no, we all Moors. It's not a Moorish
Muslim. I want to say, but
well, yeah, we can say
bad.
Muslim.
You could, yeah, you I don't want to cause
be a,
no.
Yeah, you could be a Moorish Jew. You could be
schisms.
Whatever. No, you could be a Moorish Jew. You could be whatever. But listen, the reason why the history of the Moors are not being told the way it should be told is because why would your oppressor teach you about this?
Exactly.
Why would your oppressor teach you anything about who you are?
Exactly.
When you enslaved them first. You
exactly.
follow me? So again, when you understand a Caucasian, where the term is, look up the word, y'all. Again, my brother just said it. I tell people to look it up. You ain't gonna hear nobody else say look this information.
All
up,
the
right?
time. Look it all up.
Caucasians means dead Asians. Elijah Muhammad used to say we were the Asiatics, right? The whole planet was called Asia, right? So the Caucasus means dead Asians or dead Asiatics. From the Caucasus Mountains. The Moors sent them there. So when you have a child that you disowned and he comes back and he's mature, like, you know, I tell people about my son. I haven't seen my son in years. He thought I left him. No, it wasn't me. It was your mother. I didn't want to say that, but that's what happened. But he felt some type of animosity towards me because he thought it was me. That's what they feel with the Moors. So why? I'm in power now. Why would I tell you who you are when you did this to us? They're your children. Put your children back in check. That's all you got to do.
Yeah.
And that's why they don't want you to talk about nothing about the Moors.
And that's also, you know, because I always come back because we literally have these conversations every week. And I always tell people, this is why it's so important to trace your lineage. Find out where you come from. Because, you know, Ethiopia and Moor, you know, when you read books by J.A. Rogers and others, those were the two names that were commonly used. But as time has evolved, we have also seen the emergence of Jamaicans and Haitians and Ghanaian people and Eritreans. So, you know, there are other nationalities out there besides Moor, but I encourage people to go and trace their lineage so that they know where they come from. They know what their roots are. When you know where your roots come from, you have something to stand on. You have a purpose. You begin to develop something that is bigger than you, and it encourages you to have responsibility so that you can stand up and say, listen, we need to fix this, and we need to fix this within our own house. Let's stop looking outside and let's look inward in order to fix our problem. Because just like Brother Rich said, we can't forever hold all of the responsibility on the European.
No,
we understand that the European is the person in charge. We understand that the European is we understand that the European has set up many roadblocks in order to keep us down. But those roadblocks only work if we keep relying on the European. Once you take the reliability away from the European and place it on each other, now we have then created a nation on which we can stand, and now you have the brave, you have the courage in order to defend that. But if you don't have that to build on, that which is your own, you will continue to be in fear and depend upon the European.
He made a very important point. I want to just say this in conclusion to my participation on your show, and thank you very much for that. I really appreciate that. But we only face those roadblocks if we keep taking the same path.
Exactly.
There you go.
Exactly.
Bottom line.
There you go.
Right.
We take our own path. Would you put a roadblock in your own path?
Exactly.
But see, I, you know, I'm in the
good
words.
Point.
Exactly. Exactly.
They say light penetrate darkness, dude. No, that's just how it is.
And that's why I fuck with you, because
speak on it.
Fuck with me.
because you're about getting the information out. You're not about hoarding the information.
Oh, no, I can't
and
do
people
that.
And people who know you understand that this is what you do. So at a certain point, yes, you got to contribute some funds. And that's totally respectable, because that's how you make your living. But you don't just hoard all of the information until somebody pays you.
No, I can't do
and
that.
And that's why I rock with you, because this is our job. Somebody gave us this information. We didn't study for years and years and years and develop this all on our own. We were given help. We were pointed in the right directions. And there are many people who are looking for this information, but they don't know where to look. And that's why I say start with these small books, because when you read this book, now, we know when you read a book, there's a bibliography in the back, and that tells you where he got his sources
What's
from.
What's a bibliography?
A bibliography just says where if he came up with a quote or if he came up with some information that wasn't his,
It's
he,
a reference for all
he
materials.
He tells you where he got it from.
But, see,
but also what he does is he gives you other books inside his speeches for you to go and read that are not covered in the bibliography. So from this book, you'll come away with 34 other books that you can therefore go read and get more information.
Listen, let me say this, and I got to give a shout out to my one of my teachers, man. He's a living legend. He's here, still here with us, Brother Taz Tariq Bey.
Peace.
And you are so right about that, because I hear people, like, I may see something online or hear somebody. I'm like, dude, where did you get the information from? I just experienced something this past weekend. A brother quoted something that I said. I said, wait a minute, but I'm standing in the room, but you never see Sabira said that, and that's the problem. And I'm sitting there like,
wait, he quoted you?
Yeah, he said it. I'm sitting there like, whoa, wait a minute. Wait, I know I said me? That, like, but he never said, but I was in the room. But
right.
This is what happens. Like, I love what John Henry Clark says. When if I quote anything, you may hear me say, Todd said this, or Karis One said this,
right.
Or this person. And I'm sitting here and I'm listening like, yo, you didn't make that up. Like, dude, like, right after this show,
right?
Watch what I talked about, the thug and the gang.
You
and
give the
you
big
know,
bibliography of
you know,
all of
I
your
give
shows.
It where, yeah. You know, where yeah. I get it at. So,
yeah. Verbal bibliography.
You know, I'm a researcher, dude. I mean, I will research the researcher. And that's why I tell people to research me. So we will lay everything out for people so they can get it.
Mm-hmm.
And I see people going on YouTube and saying, yo, I heard this on YouTube, dude, but that's not correct. You know?
Right.
I hear it in my classrooms when I give classes. I'm like, that's not true. Somebody trying to get you hurt.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Or they say, well, I got somebody try to sell me some paperwork for $1,500 or $2,000. No lie, Rich. This is what goes down. And I'm sitting here.
I'm aware.
Brother Taj and myself do not do that. We do not sell paperwork to nobody. We tell you to go get this, but for our time, you do this.
Right, right.
This is what we do.
Right.
So
and that's how you eat.
And
so
that's how you do it.
You got to respect that.
Not for paperwork.
Right.
Not for somebody's paperwork.
Right.
Because really, I can shut up today or tomorrow. I was offered many positions and a lot of things, and I said I can't do that.
Right.
Because it wouldn't sit right with me. You see what I'm saying? Rich
yeah.
knows this. Rich gave me, he told me one day, well, Sabir, what did you tell me, Rich? Someone's going to come to me. And what did you say to me one day?
Someone will come to you and offer you an amazing opportunity on mainstream terrestrial broadcasting, but you're not going to be able to speak your own truth.
See?
And walk your own path.
Right.
Now, what
they will
do?
Buy you out.
See?
And that's where the term sellout comes from.
See what I'm
yeah.
saying?
Because they'll
did
buy
that,
you out.
If I did that, that's what would happen.
Right.
But I'm crafty enough to know how to manipulate and how to do it.
You're in,
but
you have enough integrity to
exactly.
know.
Exactly. But people don't understand that, Rich. And I said this many times. When Rich was telling me this, I'm sitting saying, damn, he sound like the dude. Like, you know, when I got out here, they told me that. Like,
yeah.
Yo, Sabir, if you do this, we'll give you this.
You got everything you need to be prime time.
Exactly.
Let's keep
good.
It real. If you want to sell out. I mean, Richard Bey had a show. Sabir Bey can have a show.
Exactly.
We don't remember the Richard Bey show?
I don't remember that show.
You don't remember the white guy, Richard Bay?
No, dude.
Oh, man, you guys are hilarious.
Man, I'm 31. Yeah,
he was one of the first reality TV shows out here. And he predated
he was Caucasian. That's why
the the Jerry Springer show in terms of ignorance on TV in reality.
And here I thought he held the crown for ignorance.
So if you wanted to take your Bay to prime time, well, there's a price for it.
But there's a difference between my
and
Bay
and you're not
his
that
Bay.
Kind of dude. You ain't built like that.
My Bay is B E Y, not a B A Y.
Right. No, he was B E Y, believe it or not.
Wow.
He was white. It's just one of those weird things.
So he's not white. He's European. But
well, whatever.
Carlo, you still there on the line?
Yeah, I'm still here. My thing is, like, we just need more of you guys out on the East Coast, especially down south in the Bible Belt.
You do have brothers on the East Coast.
You're not getting this kind of information that you guys are giving out, and you don't have any black bookstores, you know?
Wow.
So, my brother,
been closed down.
Can I ask a question real quick?
Let me say this real quick. But what we got to do is we got to support those stores, though. But if we have them, we don't support each other. And that's the problem. Yeah. Why stores shut down. I know a lot of stores shut down because they don't get supported.
Yeah.
You know, and this is the reality of it. You know what I mean? Claude Anderson.
Yeah, I had to go all the way to Virginia. And my wife, or whatever, we go up to our home or whatever, I had to go up to the bookstore today to get, you know.
Wow, Virginia. That's a long ride.
Well, they also have online black bookstores as well. So make sure you check that out too, brother. And they ship all over the country.
And I was going to jump in and say this. Listen, print is dying. You know, Ben Franklin said many years ago, a wise man reads both books and life itself.
Wow.
And the first word of the Quran, you know, the truth to some, it was the word read, ikra in Arabic, read. But, you know, a wise man reads both books and life itself. So the books are there, and we have to research that. But let's understand that in the new digital age, a lot of this stuff is going digital.
So you
make a good point, Anthony, that you might not be able to find the physical printed material, but that is no excuse not to educate oneself.
Yeah. Yeah.
And get that knowledge by any means necessary. And I got to say, as a closing note, this is the reason that internet broadcast is becoming the new wave of information and communication and media. Because you're not going to find it on terrestrial. You know that. TV, AM, FM, it ain't happening there.
Nope.
Sabir, for all intents and purposes, and I wish you the best of success, but you ain't gonna never make it on primetime TV. And that's my prediction. I could be wrong, and I hope I am, because when he gets rich on primetime, maybe he'll kick me down. But the fact of the matter is, truth doesn't sell, especially now.
But you know what? It's funny that you said that, Rich. And you know, I was with
truth is told.
I was in a
not sold.
I was in in Philadelphia. A prosecutor, and I always say this to people who have been following me on radio for the years. Prosecutor told me, "There's no money in the philosophy of law unless you give it a lecture. There's only money in the practice of law." And it was funny. My comeback was
amazing.
My comeback was to him, "I'm not practicing. I'm done practicing. I'm finished with that part." So I said, "It's like a, you know what I mean?
I'm doing it."
So I'm doing it. Yeah. So it was funny because he looked at me,
I am,
and it was
law.
A Europe. I still remember the dude's face when I was walking on Water Street. We was on 13th and Walnut walking.
I know
this
exactly
over
10
years
at,
ago. You know what I mean? And I'm laughing. I'm walking with him because he spotted me in a law library, and he was like, you know, he will always see me. So we just happened to bump into each other, and we started walking and talking. He said, "There's no money in the philosophy of law unless you give a lecture." But the problem is with us, we don't value that. You know, and shout out to Karen McGee, because my assistant always says, "Sabir, stop talking to people so much. Because once they get you to talking, you start talking, they ain't going to pay you." This is what she told me.
And it happens when you get to be my age.
You know,
you stop talking so much.
You know,
but that's what happens when you have love for your people.
Exactly.
When you have love for your people, you want them to have the best.
Exactly.
You want them to have the most information that they can take with them and that they can build on.
Exactly.
And it happens to us all. I be on rants all of the time. Because you want, you and this is who we are. This is part of the essence of being black. We love each other.
Yep.
We want each other to be in the best position possible. It has only been through the influence of the European that we have developed this animosity and this hatefulness for each other. Now when you look at antiquity, there were wars within the different tribes, but there was never a time to where, even when these people were conquered,
they were coming together,
you still came and fought with us, you still were given a life. You still weren't separated from your culture.
Exactly.
It wasn't until you had European influence that you were entirely cut off from your culture and your history.
That's true. That's why I'm turning the mic. I'm turning everything over to you, bro. I'm handing the staff a ride. You're going to deal with it.
And we have that responsibility. And when you have that information, the responsibility falls on you to give it to somebody else.
And bro, you know, talk is cheap.
Because we got to
speak. Is speak your truth. Talk is cheap. You guys are beyond the talk of it.
Yeah,
you're actually into the speaking of truth of it. I've watched this show. I've watched Sabir. I see you guys speak your truth. Talk is cheap, but speaking it and speaking your truth makes the difference between just saying it and actually living it.
Yeah.
Hey, brother, what's your name again, brother?
Curtis.
Curtis, hit me up on Facebook, man. Inbox me on Facebook. It's just my name, Sabir Bey. I like I said, I'm on the East Coast. We can probably work something out. Again, I'll be over there. We need to be setting up these things like Malcolm used to do back in the day, having those meetings. You can have small meetings in your house, dude, and let them grow. And people don't realize that's how colleges got started. They started in people's basements and in those small sections, and they started putting funds in and built it more and more. We got to understand history. And Claude Anderson is a deep brother who breaks a lot of stuff down. And he said one of the major keys in with us is media. He was talking about the press.
Yeah.
And I keep stressing that to people, we need to back our own press. And he talked about it. He said, Sabir, where you at is where people need to be supporting. But that right there.
Back around mediums. This is a medium for truth.
But that's what I'm saying. But he was just talking about media, period, about what needs to be backed. And he's been doing it since, he said, since the 60s, I believe it was.
And that Powernomics book is amazing. I've only seen excerpts. I still have to get mine. And that's the great thing about education, that there's always something for you to learn. Once you get to a point where you feel like you can't learn anymore, you're no longer useful to the people.
Exactly. Listen, y'all, we got to go back into some more music real quick, brother.
Can I leave you with one last thing, and then I'll be done, and you can play your music. You can even go over if you like.
Go ahead.
Khalil Gibran. Learn the words of wisdom uttered by the wise. Live them. Do not make a show of reciting them, because those who repeat what they do not understand is no better than a donkey loaded with books. Khalil Gibran.
That went over some of y'all heads, but go back and listen to it later after you had a few drinks when you could process things better.
Got to regurgitate that a couple times.
Man.
Took me a long time.
Fire.
Thank you very much for the time, brother.
Yes, sir. Having hit the pavement, these beats we created be inebriated, meaning intoxicating. Believe we made it. Now we can see they faded. Them hoes done went from me so horny to me so hated. From hip hop, we never deviated. Come to the temple, hear the flow, and you can see me stated. That knowledge reign supreme. I'll be on them same streets with them same hustlers and fiends. But hip hop, do you know what it means? It means victory over the streets. Check the last Beat Street scene. Elite knowledge, inner standing, wisdom. KRS the type to get you out of the prison. Elite knowledge, inner standing, wisdom. KRS the type to get you out of the prison. Believe. You can believe what you want, you can take it or leave it. Slow it up or speed it, or never mind if you don't need it. But I still gotta teach it, I still gotta speak it. There's more to the streets than guns and stuff. To all my fathers, you know one son's enough. But if you have two or three, you know they get gas from what they see on the TV. You gotta believe me, we gotta rise up. All my daughters, I beg, close your legs and try to like open your minds up before your time's up. And you find what? You was just another stepping stone for him to climb up. What, a player? No. A hoe? No. An average rhyme sayer? No. and you thought the teacher ain't still making music, KRS-One still making music.
Man.
And if you're not familiar, G Simone is actually his manager, his wife. Man, nothing gets by that sister. And that's what you need, a strong sister to handle all that.
Because yes, I'm going to tell indeed. You,
she's no joke. Shout out to KRS-One in the family that's actually traveled overseas. He left on the 17th. I know he probably's not there yet, but he said it's going to take a month on a boat because he don't fly.
Wow.
He took his whole family.
That's cool, though. You know how I feel about riding the boat. You know, I dig it. I love it.
He take his two sons and his daughter, you know what I mean, and his wife. So yeah. It's like vacation for them, man. But they on their way overseas, man. But I want to thank everybody. This
Indeed.
Time went so fast, man.
It always do, man. And people think 3 hours is a long time. And in essence, it is. But when we get to building and talking and bringing up stuff, man, it fly by.
Yes.
We got so much that we didn't even touch. Before we go, so I guess they already got bond amounts for these 6 cops.
They got bonds?
I guess.
That's what they... Come on, dude. They got a union, my dude.
But the point of me saying that was that I don't know if you saw the video of the young bull who smashed the window in with the cone. With the traffic cone. His stepfather got him to turn himself in. Why? I don't know. He must have saw the video of the mother slapping her son up and encouraged her son.
I would never tell my son.
They gave that young bull a $500,000 bond.
To destroying property?
For throwing a cone through a window of a police car. $500,000 bond.
Yo, back, man, listen, dude. This
and we only got a minute left. I wanted to get to her earlier, but we was jumping in so many directions.
We can do this on Tuesday or next Friday. We ain't giving up. I don't forget. I don't have
it's ridiculous,
I don't have amnesia.
It's ridiculous.
So I will remember to bring it back up on Tuesday and Friday. But that's insane. I would never. And stop allowing them to tell your children
exactly.
to turn themselves in.
Exactly.
Listen, a fool tells on himself. Okay,
all
stop
day.
Allowing them to tell your children to turn themselves in. I would never tell my sons to turn themselves in.
Them Europeans don't turn themselves in after they destroy all of that shit, after they team win or lose a national championship.
Niggerism.
What's the difference?
Niggerism.
You know and go mean? watch The Spook Who Sat by the Door. It's on YouTube. It's free. Go look at how it only takes a few in order to build.
Listen, man, we got, you know, that's the theme song right there.
Gotta go.
We gotta go. It's been real.
Yes.
I want to thank everybody. I want to thank my co-host, Chalky White. I got to thank, actually, my co-host on my Tuesday show, Alberto.
Al.
Sal. Hayes. I got to thank Karen McGee. Always putting up
Shout
with my,
out to Karen, man. She is
all,
phenomenal.
Putting up with all my bull. And I want to give a shout out to Anya Bay.
Yes.
Jessica Abraham Hogan for all his artwork and the promotion.
Definitely.
And yo, she puts in a lot of work, so I want to give a shout out to the whole squad, man. Again, I want to thank Richard Carr, our GM, that was sitting in with us. But listen, check me out Instagram, Sabir Bay, the real Sabir Bay.
I am Chalky White, period 81.
Yeah, man. Facebook, YouTube, everything is on it. So share the show out, y'all. Peace and love until Tuesday.
Peace.
Y'all, we out.